everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's Rixie Pixie. And does anybody else have a sweet tooth with Halloween right around the corner? Because I sure do. So I wanted to make some gummy candies today. This is the Crazy Poppin' Cookin' Gummy Candy Making Kit. And it comes with quite a few pieces in here to make your own gummy candy. And it looks like it comes with some little stencils and the dropper stuff. And I have no idea what the package actually says because I do not speak and or read Japanese. And all of the instructions on the package that I have are in Japanese. However, I did print out some English instructions for this kit today so we can do this right. So let's go ahead and get everything out of the package. All right, so it looks like we have our fork and our little outline cookie cutter things. We have a packet of some sort. Doesn't say on either side what is in it. We have a whole bunch of other packets. We have a yellow one. Oh, we have a dropper. Yellow packet, a red packet, and a blue packet. And according to the instructions, the first thing we do is take the fork and pastry cutters out from the plastic frame. So let's go ahead and do that really quickly. All right, so we have our fork. We have a little heart cookie cutter, a little fish cookie cutter, a little giraffe, and a little flower. Next thing on the instructions says we add gummy powder in the star section of our tray, and we're going to add water to trays 1, 2, 3, and the bottom tray here. All right, so we're gonna do that. So here is our tray. My tray got a little dented, but that is okay. So we're going to put the candy powder in here, and then we're going to fill 1, 2, 3, and this tray down here with water. So according to the instructions, it looks like our gummy candy powder is the bigger packet, which is the green one. And then we have a yellow, blue, and red packet, which are the color packets. All right, these are pretty easy to tear. So we're going to pour some of this. Ooh, I don't know if I want that much. Let's use our little fork to even this out. We were supposed to add water first. Add the water now. To the line. Oops. This is where the dropper comes in handy. So yeah, so we're gonna pour powder into the yellow, which I think we've already got a good amount of powder in. Next color we do is red. Open a little tiny bit. Ooh, the red powder is coming out purple. You see that? That's cool. And then the blue. Ooh, it smells like grape. Stir these up. The reason we had to put water in this bottom one is because when you stir the color, you don't want to get the color on your other, mixed in with your other ones until you actually want to mix the colors together. So that seems to be all stirred up. Let's get this in. Basically, the powders just add a little flavor and color to the water. I think I'm supposed to add the whole packet. I'm gonna have to add all of it, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put all of it in there. Let's see how this goes. It's pretty. Let's go ahead and do the red. Put all of that in there. Ooh, the red smells like great. It smells so good. I'm just using the little holes in the front to hold the tray while I mix these. I should add the rest of the yellow. Alright, so then the next step looks like. So we did that. Now we're gonna make our own colors by mixing the colors in the little bottom sections here. Ooh. Red, blue, and yellow are called three primary colors, and you can make various kinds of colors by changing the ratio. With this Gummy Land kit, you can mix red, blue, and yellow colored water to make different colors. Like red and blue will make purple. So that is very cool. Let's go ahead and play with this. Let's make some orange. It looks kind of pink in there. Now I'm gonna get some yellow. I'm gonna make orange. Not that much yellow. Okay, now we're gonna. Ooh, I made orange! I love orange. Orange is my favorite color. Let's add a little more yellow. There we go. Look at that pretty color. That's a pretty color. I made air bubbles. I made bubbles. Try to pop the bubbles. Look at that pretty color. It's pretty. It's gonna make pretty gummies. Okay, let's make purple. Get some red. Too much red. Get some blue. Ooh, oh, that's a dark purple. I like that. You see this pretty purple? Isn't that pretty? What other colors? Let's make a little red. Let's add some yellow. And then let's add some blue. What color do you think that's gonna make? Ooh! Ooh, that made a yucky color. Let's add more red. Ooh. That's a pretty color. What if we do 3, 4, 5 drops of blue. Ooh, it makes a really light purple. 10 drops of red and 5 drops of blue makes a really pretty purple. I want to make a pink. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 drops of red, 5 drops of yellow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Rinse off my little thing here. Ooh, made like a peach color. Light peach. Okay, let's make green. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think that was 10. I think it was a little bit more. I lost count of little drops. Now we're gonna do blue. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blue. And then let's do yellow. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oops. I don't normally use my left hand, but my right shoulder is getting tired from holding it up. Alright, let's see what color I made. Ooh, that's a cool green. And this is the lighter green. And this is a little bit darker. Ooh, pretty. Alright, so who's ready to make some gummies? Alright, so it looks like after we mix our own colors, we put the thinner side of the cookie cutter into the powder till it sinks, and then we're going to fill it with gummies, and then we're going to not add too much water to the pastry cutter. And then we can use a little fork to pop them out. So let's see what kind of guys we can get. Turn it this way. Oh, I got a little bit of powder in my stuff. So we're gonna let that sink down in there. There we go. Oh, I think I did it too much. Flatten this out a little bit more. Let that sink down in there. Okay. Alright, let's make a. I'm gonna put a little bit of red. A couple drops. Oh, I don't think I pushed this down enough. There we go. Alright, let's try some purple. This is fun. Alright, now does it say how long I need to let it sit in there? Wait until gummy candy is formed. Okay. Does that look like it's formed? Ooh! I think it is. Let's pull this out. Let's get our little fork here. Oh, that is so cool. That is so cool. And then we'll just flip him over so he's not sticky on one side. There we go. Oh my gosh, he is so cute. So the reaction of the colored water with the gummy powder literally turns it into a physical gummy right in front of you. That is really cool. I need to get a plate so I have some place to put these. For now, I'll put them right down here. And that is really cool. Let's see what else we can make. Let's make a flower. Let's make a little flower. So we push that in there, because that powder is what actually becomes a gummy. Now let's see here. Let's do a light green center. So we just want to put a little drop. And then let's do bright purple on the outside. Starting to pop out of there. I'll just let that sit for a second and turn into a gummy. And while we wait for that one, we can put the fish in. Do the fish bright blue. Ooh, that's cool. Let's do bright blue up until the tail. And then what color tail should we give him? How about a hot pink tail? So let's get this little flower gummy out here. Oh, that is so cute. This kit works very well. I like this a lot. I'll just toss it around in there so it doesn't get too gummy. Well, it's a gummy, but we don't want it sticky. Oh, and you can actually see the yellow center. Look at that. That is really cute. That is really cute. These are gonna be too cute to eat, guys. Put the little heart in there, and we'll do the heart next. All right, let's get the little fishy out of here. I don't know if I'm gonna turn the fishy over, because he's kind of stuck. I think I put too much water in him. I don't know. I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have flipped that over. It says don't do that. And I did that anyway. But I wanted to see what would happen. And now we have our own little Japanese Swedish fish gummy. How cute is that? That is adorable. I'll just put him there. Alright, let's get this chunk of gummy out of here. That's probably really delicious. We should just taste this, right? I'm just gonna put this in my mouth. That's really good. That's a good gummy. I can't wait to eat these when I'm finished. All right, so let's do the heart. I'm gonna kind of move this around a little bit. And I'm gonna give you guys a little bit different look at the how it turns into a gummy. Let's do I'm gonna mix some of this in here, make this a little bit lighter. Alright, and then that soaks into the powder. I don't think I put too much. You keep telling me don't put too much, and what do? I put too much. Ooh, it came right out of the cookie cutter. Flip him over and get him coated on that side. Little powdery heart candy. And there we are, a little delicious powdery candy heart. Very cool. So after waiting a little bit, the candies do harden up a little bit before he was all wobbly, but he's hardened up a little bit. Letting him sit and wait. And these ones are harder on the sides where there's more powder. They're harder and they're more squishy towards the top. But they are so cool. This worked out so well. I really, really enjoyed this kit. This kit was super fun. And the gummies are delicious. They are very, very, very good. And there's actually still a lot left in my container to make a lot more gummies. So I'm going to continue to play around with this kit and make a whole bunch of yummy, delicious candies. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you're not already and you like to be, please subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video and want to see more crazy poppin' cooking videos, please give this video a big thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!